That's the machine here. I think it looks really good. We've seen the spy shots and the camo shots and the teaser shots and the non-official shots and the official shots, but today, finally, officially, it's here. This is what the motorcycle looks like, and it looks really good. TVS is really proud of the way they've done the fit and finish, and I would agree. It's a really well-finished motorcycle. All of these little panels which meet each other are very, very evenly done. And I think the guys who did the styling have done a really, really nice job. In terms of spec, this is a very similar engine to the engine that BMW uses in the G310R. And in that sense, it's down there. It's a single that is slightly inclined at the back, and in the front is where the intake goes in. At the back is how the exhaust comes out. So if you see, that's the exhaust exiting directly, and because it exits like that, this is obviously a substantial can because it has to have all the muffling equipment because it obviously meets current emission norms. Single rear shock, KYB, freeload adjustable, upside down forks, also KYB but cartridge style, and I have to say very, very nice forks, and we'll come back to the spec in a minute, to how the bike feels in a minute. Now, as I said, the cylinder sits something like this, 6-speed gearbox, 34 PS, 27 Newton meters, and the bike weighs just 169.5 kilos. So in that sense, it should be an interesting machine to ride, and I'll come to whether it is an interesting machine to ride or not. The basics, that's what the speed unit looks like. It's actually quite nicely done. So that's your rev counter over there, gear indicator, coolant temperature, fuel gauge, and all the other information that you can cycle through is in there. In there, TVS is built in a lap timer. I'm not quite sure that they've done the machine interface right, because you have to use the day flash to record lap times. I think there are better ways to do this, but it's there, it's usable, and it's well done. Telltale lights on top and the other lights at the bottom, and you have the picture of what it looks like. At the handlebar, this is your cockpit. Notice how much detail goes into the top triple cam. TVS has said that they paid attention to making this motorcycle feel like a premium motorcycle, and I would agree. There are some places where I don't agree. So, for example, I think this particular badge, if they'd done it in metal, I think it would have been much classier instead of this plastic thing. These are first batch production motorcycles, so very, very minor issues here and there. We did ride it all day here at the Chennai racetrack. And what we immediately realized, it's a very, very easy motorcycle to ride. Abhay, it's alright, you can be in this video. It's a very, very easy motorcycle to ride. The power is extremely linear. The gearbox, which is one of the things TVS has been telling us is extra slick, is actually extra slick. We didn't miss a shift at all. Feels really, really positive. These Michelin tires, them I have two thoughts about. One, we did ride them on stock pressures at the racetrack, which is never a good idea, and I think that's the reason why right at the limit, when you're really, really pushing, you're going as hard as you can, there is some amount of movement from the tires which takes away a little bit of my confidence from the motorcycle. But I think it's a tire pressure issue more than anything else, because the rest of the package just works. It's a beautiful handler, very, very predictable, very, very calm. You can do as fast as you go, the motorcycle keeps up with you. I do wish sometimes that the excitement level from this motorcycle was a little bit higher, but on the whole, I am really, really happy. Little details on this motorcycle everywhere. For example, TVS has designed these shark fins. They're actually heat extractors. They take air from the radiator away. But if you look here, this surface has been designed as a surface that points outwards like this. So when the air comes out like this, it'll actually leave around your leg rather than on your leg. So this should be a relatively cool motorcycle to ride. There are other deflectors in place, so the hot air actually exits from there, and in that sense it should be easy to ride. It's a trellis frame that you can see. It's a bolt-on subframe that also you can see. This obviously is a frame that is very, very similar to the same frame that BMW uses on their engines, but it's not exactly the same, neither is the engine. TVS uses their own ECU for this engine, and while it makes the same horsepower, the actual gearbox gearing is the same. It also uses a one tooth larger rear sprocket. So that's the picture of the Apache. As I record this, I don't know the price yet. They haven't announced it because we've ridden the bike today and the price will come out tomorrow. You of course are seeing seeing this video after the price has been announced, so you will have an independent confirmation of the price. Let me just quickly fire it up, because yes, eventually everybody's going to say, why don't you fire the bike up and stop talking. So here goes.